So today we're looking at when things go wrong with Google My Business, and they do go wrong. In fact, it's quite easy to get your listing suspended because someone's reported it. Maybe you've just used the wrong word here. Or even when you're updating posts, you'll find that sometimes things go wrong and you'll find that it needs to then be reviewed. So I suppose one of the first things to say is when things go wrong, it's not to blow out of proportion, because most things can be sorted out. Particularly if you're trying to do the right thing, then there's no reason why, if you've made a mistake or if Google's picked up on something, sometimes Google gets it wrong at their end too. So it's worth noting, it's very common to get issues with Google My Business. Why is Google My Business so twitchy? Well, because there are lots of people doing all sorts of things out there that are considered spammy from the point of view of Google's guidelines. And therefore, their algorithm picks up on pretty much any change. If you make two or three changes that are absolutely fine with your business, quite often that will cause a suspension. It's known as a soft suspension and normally takes a day or two to get sorted. But even so, it's not pleasant to see your business, your Google My Business listing, suddenly disappear overnight. And then when it's reinstated, things are back to normal. So before I go into the five areas, the five mistakes that most people come across when they're running Google My Business, I thought I'd just look at a few of your questions that perhaps took place earlier on in this month and see if we can answer them. And at this point, what I will say is, if you've got any questions, put them down below, because if you put the questions down below, everyone benefits from hearing those answers. Now, AGIF has put a couple of great questions on the comments down below, and I've been able to answer them, and you may have come across them. But let me just review a couple of these with you. So here's the first one from AGIF. First of all, it's, some businesses, especially rent a car or cab services, usually open 24 hours. What is the most suitable way, 24 hours or 1 a.m. to 11 p.m.? So he's picked up on day two, where we mentioned about the importance of not using 24 hours and thinking that's going to give you a big advantage. And the second question he's got is, service providers like plumbers, electricians, what do they do? Because they might want to be 24 hours for an emergency. How do they set their hours? So that could be a misunderstanding really in the video, because the purpose of the video is not saying you can't do 24 hours, but it's saying don't use 24 hours thinking that's going to be better than someone who only does a 9 to 5, say, because there's no advantage either way. What must be important is you fulfill those 24 hours. So if you get a call at 3 in the morning, because you say 24 hours, well, that's the point of, or the point being made in the video. So my answer was, open 24 hours is absolutely fine if that's the actual hours of the business. And the second one was, 24 hour emergency works for services are also fine if they want to make a call early in the morning. So both of those are fine if they apply. But as I said, the 9 to 5 is not a disadvantage to 24 hours. Now, a second question was raised on day 6, AGIF put this one out. He's put there, is there any time frame to replying to reviews, and what is your idea for replying to old reviews? And so the answer really is that if you can reply to reviews within 24 hours, that'd be great, because Google monitors the time it takes for you to reply. But having said that, reply to all your reviews. What you don't want is things there that haven't been answered, because that then gives Google the idea that you're not responding to your customers. And that then doesn't look great from the point of view of being an authority. So that's what you're looking for. You're looking to show that everything gets answered. And ideally, if you can answer it within 24 hours, thanking the person for the review. And of course, there's other ways in which you might want to answer them. If they put out for a quote, if they've even messaged you, if there's a live chat, as we saw in yesterday's video, those types of things as well. Respond as quickly as you can, within reason, and you'll see that that will give the right signals to Google. So some great questions there. Thank you for those, AGIF. But of course, if you've got any questions, put them down below, because we want to help you and help others as well as they find out answers to those questions. So sometimes things do go wrong, but it's how you handle those things when they do go wrong that will probably make a big difference. In fact, if you handle it poorly, sometimes that can make the problems even worse. Now, a great quote from Henry Ford was this. He said, when everything seems to be going against you, remember that the airplane takes off against the wind, not with it. And that's the thing. Sometimes it can feel like things are going wrong, but actually you can use that as an advantage. You can find out, well, what mistakes have I made? How can I improve? What can I do to even better the business going forward? And that would be the way to handle issues that come your way with your business, particularly with Google My Business listings. But in preparation for when things go wrong, you might want to have yourself prepared beforehand. Do you know what to do if things go wrong? What do you do if, for example, you find your business is suspended? Are you fully aware of the Google support and help? And the fact you can easily now log that with Google and they will sort it out for you straight away. The problem is they don't normally give the details of what's been ringing the alarm bells for the suspension. But generally, if you just go back, if you check to see what it is you think they may have picked up on, normally it is that. So your more recent changes are often the issues that it's then raised. The fact it hasn't flagged them before would give you a good clue as to what it might be. And if you can't fix something, then do you know someone who can? But of course, when you ask someone to fix something, there's two ways to fix it. There's the right way and there's the wrong way. We often talk about white hat, black hat, grey hat. Just be aware that not everyone offers a way that's going to help you in the long term. Short term, yes, most people can help. Long term, well, that's where the trust, the authority is needed too. Here are my five quick fixes to when things go wrong and how to handle them. Number one, what do you do if a Q&A is answered incorrectly on your listing? So sometimes you have a Q&A on there and someone's answered it for you, but it's not correct. Well, the answer is just answer it correctly. And then you can upvote it as well. And in fact, if you get two or three people in the company to upvote it, then that will then become the correct answer. That will be the one that gets shown. So that's a real problem that some people have. A Q&A has been incorrectly answered. You can't actually do anything about it other than put the right answer and upvote it. So there's the first thing. So secondly, what happens if you get an unfair review? Well, you'll notice that quite often Google won't remove it and you have no ability to remove it. If you answer the review, it definitely can't be removed. So you first might want to just raise it with Google. If it's someone's put up a review and it's certainly not one of your customers, then don't answer it. Raise it through Google support. But if it's true, if someone's given you a bad review, it's unfair, then handle it professionally. So handle it well, and you may find that they'll remove the poor rating or they'll remove the comments if you handle it well. Even if they don't, if you handle it well, if people see that you can handle problems well, that builds trust too. Because every company, every business will have problems from time to time, but it's the way they handle it that builds trust with new customers. So just bear that in mind too. That's the fix, is not to deal with it the wrong way, but to handle it professionally. Now, what happens if someone adds an image that's incorrect for your business and it doesn't fit in with your business at all? Well, you can report it there on the image. You can report it to Google, explain why it doesn't fit, fill out the details that Google requires. Sometimes they want quite a lot of details. Other times it's just a simple one. But when you fill out those details and you report it to Google, Google will then review it. So it won't get removed necessarily straight away. But if it seems unfair, if it's nothing to do with your business, Google will deal with that for you on your behalf. Now, what happens if you go into your Google My Business listing and there you see an orange dot, a red dot, some orange text? What's all this about, particularly the red dot? What does that mean? Well, it means that someone's been in editing your business. The chances are that their edits are correct. It's perhaps someone who's visited your business, has added some information. Local guides can also add information to businesses to make it more rich with keywords and with information. And quite often the edits will be correct and you just need to then acknowledge it, accept it. But if there's something that's not right, well then don't accept it and delete it. Basically, as a business owner, you will get edits done by Google, by local guides, and by customers from time to time. But just be aware of them. If you want to know more about these red dots and this orange text, I did a whole video which I'll put above now, and you can go over to that video after you've completed this today and you'll find out more information about how to deal with red dots and orange text. And the fifth and final fix is, what happens if things just go wrong? What happens if I'm suspended? I can't seem to fix it. What happens if I've got real issues and I just don't know where to go? Well, Google do have a support system. They do have a help area. And it's a community that's run by people that understand Google My Business. Some work for Google, some don't. The majority are just volunteers. But actually, they will answer most of the questions. They've got a good knowledge about what the problems are. Obviously, you can put questions down below here as well, and I'll try and answer them. And I've got a community here. We've got experts that come onto these videos as well, and they'll answer them for you if I can't answer it too. But ultimately, there are some great communities where you can ask for help. Again, I'll put some links down below so you can make sure you can check out that support system that Google offers. So in conclusion, what is it you're going to do today? What are you going to take away from this video? Well, the first thing you need to do is just go in and check. Keep an eye on any changes that may have happened to your business, especially if it's an orange text change. Just keep an eye on that and make sure it's correct. Also, download the app and get email alerts and be prepared to make changes, because again, any changes that happen to your business, they'll also appear as alerts on your phone. So it's a great way of keeping up to date with some of the changes that are going on and making sure that if there's a problem, if there's a suspension, you can deal with it immediately on your app. And finally, keep yourself updated with what Google currently wants you to do, what the current guidelines are. If you get problems, there's a support system you can use on Google. And of course, you can subscribe to this channel if you haven't done so already, so that you get all the latest information about Google My Business, so that you don't miss out and your Google My Business listing stands above all the others when they rank locally. Why? Because you're doing everything that Google's asking, you're giving the right signals to Google, you're communicating well with your customers, and your customers are feeling that trust. They see you as an expert and they see you as an authority. But sometimes you may wonder, how is it that you've got the knowledge panel? Where does the knowledge panel get all its information from? Well, some of it's obvious, but it is a bit like a collage where it's taken bits from here about your business, bits from there, bits from Yelp, Facebook, it brings in social media, it brings in some of your posts, it brings in a bit of the map. All these things are coming together like a scrapbook about your business. It's important to know though, where it's getting it all from, because if you know where it's getting it all from, then you can control what it puts into your knowledge panel. And that's exactly what I'm going to do with you tomorrow. So don't miss that video. It's a really important video on day 26.